Bonjour. Okay, you don't have to use the chat box for simply asking how are you and your So, children, you remember what we learned in the previous class? We learned
accents.
And we learned in the previous class
accents.
How many accents we learned till now? How many accents we learned till now? Four accents we learned. Laxo Aegyo, Laxo Gram, Laxo Circumflex, Sedil. Also we learned in the previous class we learned Sedil accent. Let's see one more time Sedil accent and we will start the fifth. We are going to learn fifth accent today. Okay, so Sedil accent, see, wait. Okay, see the Sedil accent we learned in the previous class. Sedil and symbol is like this, half of five. And tell me, along with which letter we can see Sedil accent? Along with which letter we can see Sedil accent? Agnes, tell me, with which letter you can see Sedil accent? Along with which letter? Unmute your Agnes.
Yes, ma'am.
With which letter you can see? We can see Laxo Sedil. With letter? With letter? Letter. What is that letter?
C.
C. Trebia. Letter is C. We'll be able to see Laxo Sedil with letter C. And what is the sound of that accent when that comes? Sir, Trebia, and the sound will be sir. And we learned few examples also. First one was le garçon. Le garçon. What is le garçon meaning? Who is going to tell? Abha, tell me what is garçon?
Le garçon.
Oui, le garçon means?
Russian.
Pardon?
Russian.
No, what is le garçon? Forgot. Ayush, tell me.
Boy.
Boy. Trebia. Abha, did you heard? Garso. Le garso means boy. Okay. Then next one after that we learn another word. Le resu. Le resu. What is le resu meaning? Resu. Mayuga, tell me what is resu.
Yes, ma'am.
What is resu, dear?
Resu.
Forgot? See, please do study, everyone. Now we are the beginning, okay? Your base should be strong, so you should study every day. Not every day, at least. Every once in a week, you take French book and just revise. Fida, tell me.
Recipe.
Recipe. Trebia. Resu means receipt. Receipt. D'accord. Ensuite, l'autre exemple, c'est la leçon. La leçon. What is leçon? Leçon meaning? Abigail, tell me what is leçon?
What is
leçon means?
Boy.
No, leçon, yeah? Like this one, leçon. Leçon means? Abigail, forgot. Pardon? Come on, dear. You are right. What is leçon? Same, similar space, similar sound. Saharish, tell me.
Lesson.
Trebia. Lesso is lesson. Okay, everyone. Lesso is lesson. L'autre exemple, c'est français. What is français meaning? Français. What is français? Catherine, Aya, tell me, Catherine, what is wrong, said here?
Ma'am, French.
French. Trebia, Francais means French. L'autre exemple, c'est ça va. Ça va. What is ça va meaning? Ça va. Adidev, tell me what is ça va? What is ça va, dear?
Ma'am?
Tell me. Ça va. Ça va bien, merci. Ça va. What is ça va? Come on.
No, ma'am.
You forgot. Only few things are we are learning in a week, Drea. Please do study properly. Okay, Shine, tell me what is ça va?
Okay, fine.
Yeah, right. Ça va means okay or fine. Ça va means okay or fine. D'accord? Now, yes. So, Laxocedil, I hope Laxocedil is clear for you. See, it is not like every week I will come here and I will give you few words. We will read, practice and read, and after that, you have that, you are not, you don't have to see, look it back. Okay, you have to go back, open your book, write and study these words along with the audio that I am sending in the WhatsApp. Please do practice with that audio. Then only these words will be clear for you. Because we are at the beginning stage, we are learning now itself, starting. So now if these words are not clear, okay, then how can we move forward? Okay, everyone, please do learn these words, write and study these words. Now we are moving to the next accent, fifth accent, that is Trema. Our new accent is Trema. Trema. Please do repeat, everyone. Trema. Trema. Please do repeat, everyone. Trema. Okay. And see the symbol? Just put two dots like this. Just put two dots. Okay. Trema. Repeat, everyone. Trema. Okay, and you can see this symbol, this accent Trema, along with three letters E, U and A. Just like this, put two dots on top. Okay, E, U and A, you will be able to see Trema accent. And when Trema accent comes, you can see there where Trema accent is, you will be able to see two vowel letters coming together. Listen, everyone, stop writing, close all your books. Close all your books. Just listen, and later I will give you time to write. Okay, so this, you will be able to see Trema accent on top of three letters E, U and A. And in a word where you see Trema accent, there you can also see two vowel letters will be coming together. You will be, listen everyone here. Listen. You will be able to see two vowel letters coming together, and there you must pronounce those two vowel letters separately. You must pronounce those two vowel letters separately. Example, listen to the example, Catherine. Yeah, listen to the example. Mice. Mice is the word. Mice. Okay? Mice means sweet corn. Mice in French is sweet corn. Mice means sweet corn. Catherine, just keep your hands free. Yeah. Mice means sweet corn. Listen to the pronunciation. Mice. Mice. Okay. Here, I is having Trema symbol. I is having Trema accent. And also, you can see there two vowel letters coming together. A and I. two vowel letters coming together, and the second vowel letter will have this trema accent. Okay, second vowel letter will have this trema accent, and that time when you see trema accent, you must pronounce those two vowel letters separately. So I, A and I. How will you read A in French? How will you read A in French? Ah. A in French is A, and I pronunciation in French is E. So I. Okay, A and E sound. I. Mice. Should those two vowel letters should be clearly audible separately. Mice means sweet corn. And we have another word in French. Agnel, are you listening here? Agnel, listen here. Yeah, we have another word in French, that is same spelling, see, M-A-I-S. But this time, trema accent is not there. This time, trema accent is not there, but same spelling, M-A-I-S. Okay, without trema, pronunciation is also different. May. Pronunciation is may, and even meaning is also different. Both are two different words with different pronunciation, different meaning. Only change is this trema. Here in this word, trema is there. Here, no trema. Okay, and listen to the difference between those two pronunciations. Mice and may. Mice and may. May means but. And mice means sweet corn. Both are two different words with different meaning. Same spelling. Only difference is accent. Only difference is one accent. Trema accent. Because of that trema accent, pronunciation is different and meaning is also different. Listen to those pronunciation, two pronunciation clearly. First one, mice. First one is mice. A and E sound is pronounced clearly. Mice. And here, together I am reading maize. Sorry, S will be silent. Désolé moi. May. May. S will be silent here. May. See the difference? With the accent trema, axotrema, it is mice. And without trema, it is may. I hope the difference in the pronunciation is clear for you. So when you see laxotrema, that is two dots on the second vowel letter, you have to pronounce those two vowel letters separately, clearly. Okay? Now, next example. L'autre exemple, say Noël. Noël. Here, which are the two vowel letters coming here? Two vowel letters here is O and E. O. Noel. See, O and E should be clearly audible. Noel. Okay? And the meaning is Christmas. Noel means Christmas. Noel. Noel. Please do repeat, everyone. I am repeating so that you hear me and repeat after me. Noel. Then l'autre exemple, say heroine. Heroine. Heroine means heroine. Heroine. Hero and heroine. Okay? Heroine. Here, I am pronouncing as heroine. I am not saying heroine. H is silent here. Why? Why H is silent? I am not pronouncing H here. Heroine. Tell me why H is silent. Giselle, tell me. Giselle, dear, I am not able to hear you. Your audio is not coming out. Adide, CN, tell me.
Ma'am, H is a vowel letter.
H is?
Vowel letter.
Who said H is a vowel letter? H is not a vowel letter. Who said H is a vowel letter? Did I told you that H is a vowel letter? No, then H is not a vowel letter. What I told you is, if H is coming at the beginning of a word, then we will consider H as a vowel letter. I never said H is a vowel letter. H is not a vowel letter. I said, if H is coming at the beginning of a word, then H will be considered as a vowel letter. And H will be silent. And H will be silent only if H is coming at the beginning of a word. That is the reason. Because H is at the beginning of a word. That is the reason, okay? Listen everyone. Because H is coming at the beginning of a word, H will be silent. That is the reason. So, we will not pronounce here H. H will be silent. And the next letter, E, is having ague. E is having laxo-ague. See here? E is having laxo-ague. So, what will be the pronunciation if ague is the A? If ague is the pronunciation will be A. Please stop writing everyone. Mayuga, put your pencils down. I will give you time to write. Okay? So, when laxo-ague will be the pronunciation is A. That is why I read A-R-O-E-N. O-E-N. O and E are the two vowel. O and I are the two vowel letters we are having here. O-E-N. A-R-O-E-N. Yeah. Try to repeat after me. A-R-O-E-N. That E. Stretching should be there. A-R-O-E-N. Clearly should be audible. Another example say. Ire. Ire. Ire means to hate. Ire means to hate. Ire. Here also see. What is the beginning letter? Here. H is the beginning. H is coming at the beginning of a word. So here also H will be silent. And the letter, those two letters are, vowel letters are A and I. A and I, how will we pronounce in French? A, E, Air. A and E, Air. Don't say air. Remove H and don't say air. Okay, this is not air. I'm not teaching you science, the EVS word, air. No. Air. Air. H will be silent. So remove H. And after that we have A-I-R. So you are not allowed to say air. Air is in English. Okay? This is air. Air. Please do repeat after me everyone. Mice. Noel. Fida, stop writing and just listen here. Aeroin. Air. Once again, everyone, repeat after me. Mice. Noel. Hadlin. Look at the board and repeat after me. Mice. Noel. Aeroin. Air. Once again. Mice. Noel. Aeroin. Air. Okay everyone, I will clearly write this once again. I will clearly write these words and after that you can copy these words to your rough book. Trema, write the, you can write the heading Trema. Trema is having two dots, symbol is like that, and you will be able to see on top of letters E, A and U. This you have to write in your rough, okay? And first word I taught is, first word, mice. Mice. Mice means sweet corn. Sweet corn. Another example, let's say Noel. Noel means Christmas. Christmas. L'autre exemple, c'est héroïne. Héroïne is heroine. Heroine. L'autre exemple, c'est ire. Ire means to hate. Okay, you can copy this down to your rough book and later you are going to write and study these words for 5 times. Now I will be taking attendance, so when I call your name, please do respond in French itself. Okay, one more time, let's practice, and after that I will call you one by one to read. Okay, one more time, let's practice. Repeat after me. Mice, Noel, héroïne, Ire. D'accord?
Mice.
Okay. Donc, Miva, unmute and read.
Yes, ma'am.
Oui, madame, please do respond everyone in French itself when I call you. Otherwise, I will increase your imposition. One, I told you to write these words for 5 times, right? Now, not this time, Miva, no issues. After that, when I call anyone, please do respond in French itself. Otherwise, I will make you write these words 10 times. And count will increase. D'accord? Miva, read.
Mice.
Air. It's not air. That is what I told at the beginning. I am not teaching you science here. It's not air. Air. Yeah. Everyone, listen. It's not air. Air. Yes. Also to say, Mivon. D'accord. Right.
Noel.
Heroine. H will be silent. And here, when axo au is there, a sound will come. A rowing. Ensuite. D'accord. Ensuite, say très bien, Mivon. Ensuite, say Aradhya.
Oui, madame.
D'accord.
Mice. Noel. Aeroin.
Not A.
Air.
D'accord. Très bien, Aradhya. Ensuite, say Catherine. No. Sriya, just remove that hand raise symbol from there. I will call. Catherine?
Yes, ma'am.
Read.
You, madam. Mice. Noel. Heroine.
Oui.
Air.
No, it's not air.
I.
D'accord. Très bien. Once you say Agnes, girls.
Ma'am, it's not Agnes.
Agnel girl.
Noel.
D'accord, très bien, Agnel. Ensuite, say Agnel Joshi.
Yes, ma'am.
Oui, madame. So, Agnel, you are getting the imposition. You are going to write and study for 10 times, not 5 times. D'accord? D'accord? Très bien. Read. It's not maize, dear. It's not maize. How will you, what is the pronunciation of letter A in French? Letter A, how will you read? And letter I, how will you read?
Ma.
Now you read?
Ma.
Full word? Mice.
Mice.
Now, next one?
Mice. No.
Noel.
Noel.
H will be silent. What I told you? H will be silent when H is at the beginning of a word. So, think that H is not there. And the next letter, E is having like. So, ague. And the sound will be A. So, how will you read now?
Aero.
Come on, right.
Aeroin.
Then? On sweet?
Air.
It is not hair or air. See everyone, you are reading in French. Keep in mind, French letters you have to pronounce, not in English. A, how will you read in French? Air. D'accord? Oui. On sweet say Abha. Abba, unmute and read here.
Yes, ma'am.
Abba, you all have to write and study these words for 10 times.
Why, madam?
Why? Because you said, yes, ma'am. I told, oui, madam, right? D'accord. Read.
Mais, sweet car.
Only the French words.
Nile. Aeroid.
Oui.
Air.
No, it's not air.
Air.
Dako, Trevia. Once you to say.
Mercy.
Be a menu. Agnel, girls, please mute yourself. Once you to say Ivan.
Oui, madame.
Dako.
Mice. Noel.
It is not Noel. Noel. Noel.
Noel.
On sweet.
Air.
D'accord. Très bien. Ivan. On sweet say Heidlin. Mute everyone others. Agnes, please mute. Wait.
Oui, madame.
Hadlin, unmute once again.
Oui, madame.
D'accord. Read.
Maize.
No, dear. It is not May. In French, how will you read? A pronunciation, how will you read in French? A in French. Now you read.
Mice.
Once again.
Mice.
Trebia. Now next one.
Noel.
Good. On sweet.
Heroin.
We. On sweet. Next word, how will you read? Air. Air. Okay, everyone. Now, please do repeat after me. It's almost time. One more last time we will read these words. Repeat after me. Mice.
Mice.
Air. Okay, okay, dears. It's almost time. Now 11:09. So I'm ending the session. Accents are done. We completed all the accents, 5 accents. So everyone, please do study, write and study, read and practice these sounds. Okay, we'll see you in the next class. Au revoir.
Bye, ma'am.
Au revoir.